stand before you, amen, and share the word of the Lord. Let's turn into the book of John, the Gospel of John, chapter 20. John chapter 20. We are going to read from verse 24. The title of my message is Seeing and Believing. Seeing and Believing. Please talk to your neighbor and tell him how he or she looks. I can't hear you.
Thank you,
Pastor. Thank you. You look good. You look good. Amen. Very smart. Hallelujah. Pastor was smart. Hello? Eh? I like the soup and the shot. Mostly the shot. Hallelujah. Eh? Can we say the socks? Amen. So you look good, you are nice, you are beautiful, you are the best that God has in this generation. Amen. And so God is looking at you. Hallelujah. And He has confidence in you. And He has trust in you that in this generation you will produce.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
John chapter 20, verse 24. But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. And other disciples, therefore, said unto him, We have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I see in his hands the prints of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days again, his disciples were with him, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being in their midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, Reach thither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach thither my hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that are not seen and yet believe. Father, we thank you. For faith coming by hearing, and hearing your word, O God. And we as the just shall walk by faith. We thank you, for we will not only live by bread, but by every word that proceeds from your mouth. Let your word this morning proceed, O God, under the anointing of your Holy Spirit, confirming it, O God, in our lives with signs and wonders and miracles. And because you are here, that Lord, we shall not live the same as we came, Father. But God, we are living a transformed, a changed, a promoted, a glorified, justified, a blessed people to the glory and honor of your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. We all know about our friend Thomas, who we have baptized. When Jesus resurrected and he appeared to some of the disciples, Thomas was not among them. And they would tell him that we have seen the Lord. The Lord has resurrected as he promised that in the that day he shall raise from the dead. It has happened, Thomas. We have seen him. But Thomas responded and said unto them, Except I see, I shall not believe. There is this saying that we normally use, that seeing is believing. And because of the realm that we walk in, it determines whether you are in the category of those who confess that cliche that seeing is believing. Unless you see, you cannot believe. And so Jesus decided to visit his disciples. And this time, he decided to visit them because of Thomas. Not because of anybody else, but specifically, personally, exclusively, he determined to have an appointment with Thomas. And I love Jesus. Hallelujah. Although the disciples were many in the house, but this time Jesus decided that I am doing this for Thomas alone, personally. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And I want to believe that this morning, that even as he has promised, that wherever two or three shall gather in my name, I am in their midst. And I believe that today, Jesus, our Lord and our Master, is here. Amen. Because of me. Amen. I don't know about you. Ask your neighbor, do you believe that today is an exclusive encounter with the Lord? Hallelujah. Although we are a congregation, Jesus is here because of me. Amen. Then your neighbor is here because of me. You and you alone. Hallelujah. And his purpose was to transform the life of Thomas. And that is what I want to believe he has come to do into my life. And not only into my life, but into your life also, and to the life of the church. Because Thomas is the only disciple who died a natural death in India. The rest of them were martyred. But Thomas lived to the full of his years and fulfilled his purpose and died a natural death. And I declare that there shall be no premature death in our midst in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus came to change the perspective and the perception of Thomas. And that is what the Lord is about to do today. Hallelujah. He is changing our shame, our disgrace, and our reproach into glory and honor today. Our insufficiency, our lack, and our want from to plenty and satisfaction. He is changing our secret tears into open reward. He is changing our unspoken to a public testimony. That is what the Lord is about to do. And the any time, in any moment, at any particular time or place, but he chose after 8 days that that was the time that he was about to visit Thomas. And we are entering into our 8th day. Hello? Tell your neighbor, he's visiting you. And my desire today is that please believe. Believe that he is here. Believe that he is visiting you. Believe that his intention is to change your life. Believe that when you leave this place, whatever burden, whatever situation that you came with today, it will not be able to withstand his presence. They cannot share you and that burden because he is a jealous Lord and he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and that he shall reign in your life. Hallelujah. After 8 days, tell your neighbor, after 8 days. And we all know that numbers have significance. And that is why Jesus chose number 8. Hallelujah. Because we know number 8 is a number of new beginning. Amen. Today is our day of new beginnings. Hallelujah. Today is our day of entering into new dimensions. Because when we attend into this place, even at the old times in the Bible, our passage normally tells us that the temple had two gates, the southern and the northern. And when you enter with the southern, you are not permitted to live with the southern, but you are allowed only to live in the northern. In other words, the way you came is not the way you will live. You will live a transformed person. We are entering new dimensions. We are entering into new realms. We are entering into new spheres. We are entering into our season. Our season of plenty and satisfaction in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible tells us, remember not the former things, neither consider the old, for I am doing a new thing. Today God is doing a new thing in our lives. And I want to ask you, please believe. Believe in this God. Of them that seek him diligently. Because you didn't come to seek anybody. You came to have an encounter with him. And so number 8, we are forgetting the former things. Remember them not. Whatever you have experienced, whatever you have gone through in this life, today I believe that it is the day that God is ushering us into that new season, a season of plenty and satisfaction. Whatever that has been contrary into our lives against the will of God. Oh, let me preach to myself. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor a new season. Plenty and satisfaction is my portion. Tell him. I am telling myself. You tell your neighbor or tell yourself that plenty and satisfaction is my portion as I leave this place in the name of Jesus. Number 8, it is a day that God commanded the children of Israel that every male child shall be circumcised. Hallelujah. The 8th day was a day of circumcision. And the Bible tells us we are of them that are of a circumcision that worship God in spirit. Hallelujah. And the circumcision was a token, a sign. It was a token, a sign to Abraham and God, because of the covenant that God had with Abraham. And it was for God when he sees at Abraham and sees the conqueror, the sign of circumcision, then he will remember that he had a covenant and that he is a God that keepeth his covenant and his promises are yea and amen. It was an initiation, hallelujah. It was a mode of entrance into covenant with God, that whatever God has promised that he will do. And he has said, I am Lord God, I shall not break my covenant, nor alter the word from my mouth. Have I promised? I will fulfill it. It is a sign that we are in covenant with God through Jesus our Lord. And whatever that belongs to the Father belongs to us, to the covenant and the promise in the name of Jesus. Because we have a token, we have a sign. Salvation is a token. Salvation is a sign that everything that belongs to God belongs to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The eighth day was also a day that this male, after he was circumcised, he was given a name. Hallelujah.
Wow.
He was given a name. The name, hallelujah, the name that I came with today as I entered into this place, it is not the name that I shall leave this place with. Hallelujah. Because God is giving me a new name. Oh, I love that. God is giving me a new name. And what is the significance of a name? A name was a prophetic projection of purpose and destiny. It defined, a name defines your purpose and your destiny. It is a prophetic projection. And that is why whenever God encounters with a man, he changes his name. He changed the name of Abraham to Abram. Why? Because his destiny and his purpose here on earth was to become a father of many nations. Today, I am leaving this place with a new name. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A new identity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A new identity. Oh, yes. A new identity. Hallelujah. Not with men, but a new identity with God. And also, in identity, in the old, people had garments. But see, they had garments. Hallelujah. And these garments determined their social status. These garments determine who they are according to their garments. And that's why you remember that prodigal son, when he came back home in Luke 15 verse 22. Hallelujah. The Bible says that he came with the mentality of a servant. Hallelujah. And when he encountered the Father and said, Father, do not make me one of your servants. I am not worthy to be called your son. But the Father said, you cannot be a servant. Bring the best robe. Hallelujah. Because servants never wore robes. Robes were not worn by ordinary people. They were worn by kings, by prophets, by nobles, by rich people. Hallelujah. So a garment determined your social status and distinction. And God is clothing us today. Oh, I feel as if this preaching belongs to me. Hallelujah. Amen. Genesis 38 verse 14, the Bible speaks of Tamar, who was a daughter-in-law of Judah. And Judah could not give his sons to him, because the first one died and the second one, and he said, this woman has something. I won't give him my third child. He might kill her. Hello? And so the Bible speaks of Tamar, and she did put Numbers chapter 3, speaking of the king, hallelujah, when he was brought forth out of prison. And the Bible says, and he did put off his prison clothes. Esther chapter 4, verse 1 and 2, when Haman determined that he will kill all the Jews. And the Bible says that Mordecai put on sackcloth, speaking of sorrow. In other words, there are garments that we have been clothed with in our life, in our journey of life. There are clothes that we have been clothed with, garments by the experiences that we have gone through. There are garments that people have clothed us by the way they look at us, by the way they see us. But I want to say, in the name of Jesus Christ, today, hallelujah, the Lord is changing our garments. When Matthew, verse 15, when Bartimaeus heard that it was Jesus who was passing by, and he began to shout and to cry and to call upon the name of Jesus, and the people who were with him commanded him and said that to him, shut up, keep quiet. But when Jesus heard him and turned and said, bring him here, the Bible says that, and he cast away his garment, the garment that was upon his life that defined him as a blind beggar. Hallelujah. When Jesus called his name, when Jesus had an appointment with him, even as he has an appointment with us today, the way he chose to visit Thomas, we are casting away our garments. Whatever garment that has been placed upon our lives, we are casting them away. I delight in the Lord. My soul shall joyfully in my God. For he has clothed me with a garment of salvation. He has covered me with a robe of righteousness. Hallelujah! A garment of salvation. And when we are talking of salvation, we are talking a garment that represents that God is going to do everything that is required in my life for me to attain every good promise that he has for my life. A garment of salvation, and he has covered me with the robe of righteousness, that when I stand before him, I am righteous, I am right standing, and I am qualified to receive.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. And verse 27 of John, chapter 20. Then said he, Thomas, reach, hallelujah. Stretch yourself, reach, hallelujah. The Lord is here. He has visited you. He has come before you because of you personally. An inclusive, hallelujah, encounter with the Lord. But the Lord is saying to Thomas, Thomas, reach out, stretch yourself, hallelujah. Stretch yourself and reach out to whatever the Lord has brought you this morning. Because he will not never gather his people in vain with a purpose. He said, Thomas, reach, stretch, and be not faithless. Believe, hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, believe. Oh yes, we say that the covenant that we have spoken of with our God through his son Jesus, the requirement for us to walk in the covenant is only to believe. God does not require so many things from you. He only requires that you believe.
Tell your neighbor, requires that
you believe. Thomas, hallelujah, because you have seen, because thou hast seen, thou hast believed, but blessed,
amen.
Blessed, hallelujah, blessed. say, are they that have not seen, and yet they have believed. Blessed, hallelujah. Are they that have not seen, yet they have believed. Hello? Why are they blessed? They that have not seen, and yet they have believed, they are blessed because the work that we walk with, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7, the Bible tells us that we walk by faith and not by sight. It is not by sense knowledge. It is not by seeing. It is not by touching. It is not by what I am feeling. It is not by what the world is seeing in me. It is by faith. Our walk is a walk of revelation knowledge from the word of God and what God has said concerning us. It is for us to believe and stretch our hand of faith and believe, even though we have not seen that prosperity, even though we have not seen our unspoken being turned into public testimony, even though we have not seen our secret tears being turned into an open reward, even though we have not seen our shame, our reproach, and our disgrace turned into honor and to glory, even though we have not seen, we are not walking by what we see, we are walking by what has been conceived in our hearts. We are walking by faith and not by sight, not by sense knowledge. We are walking by what the word of the Lord says. It is not by sight, but by faith. For Hebrews 11 verse 1, the Bible tells me that now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Evidence of things not seen. I don't have to see them. As long as faith is in my heart, I believe for those things that are not seen, that they are there. For we live in a dual existence. We are physical, but we are spiritual. And spiritual is more who we are, more than physical. We are spiritual beings, clothed with a physical being. We are spiritual beings, clothed with a physical body. Hallelujah. And so, the evidence of things not seen. 2 Corinthians 4 verse 18, why we look not at the things that are seen, but the things which are not seen. For the things that are seen are temporal, but the things that are unseen, they are eternal. We look with our spiritual eyes, our eyes of faith. We look at those things which are not seen, for the seen are temporal. That situation that you are in, that is physical, is temporal. It is Salamasha. It is temporal. It is for a while. It is for a moment. If only you can see the unseen. Hallelujah. If only your eyes of faith can see. For we don't walk by, we don't look at those things that we see by our eyes, but those things that are not seen. My blessings, I choose to see my blessings. I choose to see I am successful. I choose to see that I am prosperous. I choose to see that I am healed. I choose to see that I am the head. I shut up. It doesn't matter what you see. Amen. When you look at me, I have chosen. Now, can't you see me? Hallelujah. Amen. For the things which are seen are temporal. Yes. They are for our while. They are for a moment. And they have come to pass. Tell your neighbor, they have come to pass. That joblessness, whatever, I don't know what it is, but whatever that you can see with your eyes, it is temporal and it is for a while and for a moment, and it has come to, it will pass, it came, it met you, it will leave you and go, and you will remain standing, for we are not looking at the things that are seen, but the unseen. Why? For any unseen, the Bible tells me in Hebrews 11, verse 27, by faith that he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, not fearing the visible, not fearing what can be seen with the eyes, not fearing, hallelujah. Why? For he endured, seeing him who is invisible. For we don't see those things that are seen. Moses endured seeing him who is invisible. As long as you will endure that while, that moment, as long as you endure it, seeing him who is invisible, the Bible tells me that you will call those things that are not, those invisible, those unseen, you will call them as though they are. They are. You call them, hallelujah, because you are seeing the invisible. You call them. Tell your neighbor, you call them. Why call them? This is the testimony of Paul on his way to Rome. And the Bible says in Acts 27, verse 25, where was I? Be of good cheer. Be of good cheer. As long as you can see the invisible, be of good cheer. Hallelujah. The visible is temporal. It is coming to pass. It will pass. I say that situation will pass. That condition and confine you. It is there for a moment. As long as you see the invisible, it is coming to pass. Be of good cheer. Tell your neighbor, be of good cheer. Celebrate, hallelujah. It is well with my soul. For he has taught me to see. It is well, hallelujah. Regardless of my situation, it is well with my soul. For it is not what I see, it is what I believe. I cheer up. I choose to cheer up. Hallelujah. I choose to cheer up. I choose to be joyful. I choose to rejoice up. For I know, hallelujah, that whatever I am going through, it is for a while. It is for a moment. It came to pass. It will pass. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes. Oh, glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I am enjoying myself because I am preaching to myself. Oh, I don't know about you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he said, wherefore, sir, cheer up. Sir, be of good cheer. For I believe God. I believe God. I don't believe in my situation. I don't believe in my circumstance. I don't believe in what I am going through. They were in a shipwreck. They were in a shipwreck. They were about to die. Hallelujah. But Paul is declaring and he's saying, I will cheer up in this situation because I believe God. I believe God. Hallelujah. I don't know who you believe in. Hallelujah. But I'm chosen to believe God. Oh my God. I choose to believe God. Hallelujah. That it shall be even as I was told. It shall be even as I was told. Hallelujah. It shall be even as I was told. I believe. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 1, verse 45. And blessed, hallelujah. And blessed is she that believed, that began that of a shokoto. For there shall be a performance. There shall be a performance. It
series, you are believing that unlocks the mighty, omnipotent hand of God, and it causes it to divinely intervene in your life and perform.
Wow. Amen.
There shall be a performance of those things which were told of her from the Lord. Today there is a performance. There is a performance of my miracle. There is a performance of my breakthrough. Today there is a performance of my change of garment. Doesn't matter the garment. Thomas, only believer. For blessed is he that has believed, even though he has not seen, as long as.
Amen. Amen. Today I am not finishing as usual.
Hallelujah. John chapter 6, verse 47. The Bible says,